What does mechanical and aerospace engineering have to do with cancer research? When it's the Cellular Mechanobiology Laboratory, which focuses on the effects of mechanical forces on cell function, everything.
The aim of this work is to find another treatment method that will prevent the cancer from leaving one part of the body and going somewhere else and causing a new cancer.
Venkat Maruthamuthu, an assistant professor in mechanical and aerospace engineering, joined forces with electrical and computer engineering professor Mounir Laroussi, whose well-known research sparked a revolution in cold plasma technology when he and his team at ODU invented the plasma pencil, a handheld device that emits a stream of low-temperature plasma without harming healthy cells, ultimately killing harmful bacteria and healing wounds.
We create plasma in our laboratory at atmospheric pressure and at room temperature, and we use it for biomedical application. We use it to kill pathogens like bacteria. We use it to kill cancer cells too. So a lot of our research is focused the last few years on the application of low temperature plasma to killing cancer cells, and hopefully with the goal of developing some new cancer therapy based on low temperature plasmas.
Over the past few years, Laroussi's group has carried out successful experiments on cancer cell lines, including those associated with leukemia, prostate cancer, and carcinoma.
What's very exciting about the work we are doing, it's applied to a very important medical challenge. There are technologies out there that are used, but they have terrible side effects to the patient.
Even with all of his success, there was still an underlying challenge. Laroussi wanted a better understanding of how plasma affects cell migration or metastasis, which is when a pathogenic agent, such as cancer, moves from one site in the body to another. That's where Maruthamuthu's mechanical engineering expertise comes in.
In cancer, the main problem is the unlimited divisions that cells in the body undergo. So when they divide nonstop, it becomes a problem, and we call it cancer. What we're trying to do is to use plasma radiation to see how we can stop cells from dividing nonstop.
Maruthamuthu and his students put cells on a dish, treat them with plasma radiation, and using an advanced microscope, observes what happens to those cells over various time intervals.
Using this approach, we found that not only does plasma radiation kill cells at a high dose, but at low doses, we can also stop the proliferation or dividing of cells, which helps us understand the effect of plasma on mammalian cells. If we can do this, then people who have cancer can have another treatment hope that can possibly increase their lifespan.
This partnership between electrical engineering and mechanical and aerospace engineering has the potential to make a significant impact on the rapidly growing research field of plasma medicine, where engineering, physics, life sciences, and chemistry come together to address solutions to the world's greatest medical challenges. It also creates incredible opportunities for students.
Any student who has scientific curiosity and who wants to not only learn but contribute and work with cutting-edge technology can do this work at the College of Engineering of Old Dominion University, working in a lab such as mine.
For the Batten College of Engineering and Technology, this is Keith Pierce.